been done.
Amen.
I hate to say you this. That includes me, all of us. We're sitting comfortably inside this church like that ship. We don't want to step outside because we might get hurt. Yes, somebody is going to get hurt. Look at that movie. That man jumped into the water, the storm. If you look at the reality of that one act itself, if you know anything about the ocean, the odds are very slim he's going to make it. The odds are very slim that he's even going to make it to the person to rescue, let alone when he gets to rescue them, can he do anything? But God is not asking that. God is asking you to jump off of that boat, swim towards that sinner at all costs. He's not asking, are you going to feel okay? You see, a lot of us are like the ship in there. It's comfortable. I don't want to step outside because I'm going to face ridicule. And anyway, they're just, what did he say? Drug dealers. Drug dealers. I love what he says because that is so true today. They're getting what they deserve. That's what they say. The question is, we're really getting what we deserve. We're just Christians locked inside of a building, if you want to call us Christians. I'm talking about our mission. Brother Micah's leaving. Brother Danny is left. I look at them as casualties. One of the lifeboats is sunk. But look how many people us here right now. Each one of us is a lifeboat. Are we going to go out into that raging storm and do what we're supposed to do? I'm sick and tired of hearing people say, I don't like that music. It's not right kind of music. That's the reason we're going to go into that storm and make an urban church here. Today is the first day of mission on a run, church on a run, going to urban. They're being neglected because they don't like their lifestyle. The church doesn't like how they dress. The church doesn't like what they say. The church doesn't like their music. Who cares what the church thinks? It's what God thinks. There's the problem. What is our mission? Our objective? Our objective is to reach them. Go into that storm. Start bringing everybody in this. This place should be a hospital room. A place where you get repaired and get back out there. You just don't get healed and take it easy in here. Let me tell you something. In World War II, General Patton had a problem. General Patton did not like cowardice. And there's a movie made about it. How he went and yelled and told him, you take this coward out of this room where all these wounded soldiers are. I don't want him to infect them. What are we doing today? We are infecting all the other Christians with Christians that don't want to do anything. We need to stop right now, right here. As I heard in a movie one time, I'm also tired of hearing people saying there's not enough opportunities here. Open the door and look at all the houses. There is enough opportunity. How many people live in St. Cloud? And you tell me there's not enough opportunity. How many people go to the bars and you tell me there's not enough opportunity? Well, I have to say this. There's a way to approach your bar. There's a way to approach a person on the street. You don't condemn. I love chaplains. I'm a chaplain. And one of the worst things you can do is to condemn somebody. And when I was going to chaplaincy school, I remember what this one person said. He said he was sitting in an area and they were passing a hat to buy beer. And he was going there, and all of a sudden, someone didn't realize that he was a pastor and a chaplain, and the hat went right to him. And everybody stopped, because they were all bikers. You're like, ooh, what are you going to do here? Do you know what he did? He put $20 in that, dropped it in. He wasn't encouraging them to drink, but he was letting them know, I'm in the room with you. And when they tried to kick him out of that church, you know what happened? They all actually came. He went in the hospital for about a week, and they tried to take over the church. You've heard of things like this, and push him out. All the homeless and the bikers all came to the church, filled the place to maximum, and they said, "Can we say something?" And they said, "Sure." This is true, what I'm telling you. They said, "I don't go to church, but I know there's a God. But when I'm ready to accept Jesus, I want Him to be there to pray with me." You see, we're kicking those people out of the church today. We're kicking them out of the church. We need to reestablish our mission. Right now, Church on the Run is going urban for a reason. There's a mission out there. A job that needs to be done. I'm tired of seeing people in the newspapers talking about getting shot. I don't see the mention of Jesus Christ anywhere. I'm saying, I don't see anyone supporting them. I don't see people visiting someone in jail because they need to be visited. How many times have you heard a church, someone say, "Let's go to jail and find somebody that hasn't been visited"? One person. You don't find that. Why? Because it's evil over there. That is your job. You have a protector. His name is Jesus Christ, the Son, the Holy Ghost. God Himself is going to protect you, so you don't have to worry about, are you in an area that's really bad? And when God is with you, nothing can happen. Now you look at me. I look pretty white because I guess I am. In fact, I've been told I look a little redneckish. I have no problems with that. But I'll tell you how trusted God can help you. Does anyone here know where 22nd and Paramore is? That's not a good area, is it? I went there to visit Brother Larry. And I made a mistake. I left my keys in the car. There's more story. My wife, I say that she wanted to lock stuff. I was waiting when the keys were in the car. And here it is, New Year, and I thought I was on the set of that movie, Friday Night, you know, the party movie? Because as I looked, you know the one where they have the guy has the pool, but it's really green water and some chairs in it? You know the movie I'm talking about. Next Friday? Yeah, next Friday. I thought I was in Next Friday, and I'll tell you why. I'm next to my car, and they got these free white chairs, the plastic ones. You know, you can't smoke them. They're always bent for someone about 400 pounds Saturday. And sitting in there, and on top of it is a TV. Now, the plug is going to one house, and they got a cable coming from another house to the TV. I knew where I was. That's just how it was, right? And my keys are locked in the car. Now, I should be scared, but the neighborhood came out. All of them. One lady, I'm not lying to you, came out with a spatula, a brush for cleaning bottles, and I think she had this large serving fork. Now, I don't know how she's going to open. So they all go around. That's the reason one of my windows doesn't work right, because the kid got his hand into the car. I'm not going to do that. And they were arguing who was the best thief. And they're trying to get into my car. And I'm noticing cars are going by, but the crowd is getting bigger and bigger. Right? We became the entertainment source of that night. But you know what? I didn't fear anything. They're calling me Rev. Down there, that's what they call me. Hey, Rev! I didn't worry. I can go down there in that one individual spot, not saying the whole thing. And I can go down there next to the mini bar. There's two mini bars right there. I can go near there, and they call me Rev. But when someone needs to go to church, or pray for, they'll talk to me. You see, that's what we all need to be. Now, there are some, very few, mind you, very, very few, that are to reach the Tiger Woods. But that's only a small percentage. The rest of us are like on 22nd and Paramount. That's us. God told us to go there. God commanded us with the Word Himself to go there. He will protect you. I was in 22nd Paramore. The only thing I was worrying about were they going to shatter the windows when they got my keys. But believe it or not, someone actually got it open and got the lock up. But the whole point was I never was scared. But I was there as a minister and as a friend. I was there as a friend and a minister. Not a minister and a friend. When was the last time we did something like that? Said the heck with what we're supposed to be like. The heck of how we dress. Who cares who you're married to? Who cares what color you are? Who cares what language you speak? Who cares what your rap sheet looks like? Because God told you to go. We got to get out of this comfortable house. I see saints, and I use that word very loosely, saints coming up here and sitting here, sitting in these chairs up here, telling us how to live. And then you know when they step out the pulpit, they're going to preach about things that shouldn't be preached about, making judgments on people. That's not saying what they do outside. God didn't tell you to make a judgment on somebody. He had a mission for you to do. Now, look at this way. If you have a job, do you think you're going to get fired if you start telling the boss how to run things? Imagine, let's just put a realistic thing. You go to Burger King and you're going to do the fries. And you start telling the manager your accounting system is really off base. You're ordering the wrong food. And all you do is complain. Guess what? You're not going to work there. Well, in the church, we don't fire them. We just promote them. I'm serious. I'm dead serious about this. We promote them. They're a good Christian because they know how to complain, but they're not doing anything. You know, don't complain unless you have a remedy. Don't tell me how to fix something until you know how to fix. Now, it may not be right, like the lady with the brush, the spatula, and I think the fork, but she was trying. She was really trying. I'm just saying, God, she didn't get that spatula stuck in that door. You know? But the whole point was she was doing something. We're changing every day. Let's stop promoting because it's good and just say to forget it. Forget that. We need to get out of there. You see, in here it's dry. Everyone's saved, supposedly. We got God around us, but we won't step out of that door. We won't go where we need to go. I'm getting ready to close here. I was going to preach about something else, but the mission and what we're supposed to do is more important. It's more important to talk about and then do what we're supposed to do. Forget about the talking. Forget about the how we look or what people think about us. You know, I was going to work the other day and I made a revelation. I'm a nurse. And one of the kids I take care of takes a lot of medication because he has insecurity problems. He's worried what people will think about him. Why don't we stop worrying what people think about us and think what God will think about us? I don't care what you think about me, no offense. I don't care what the Church of God thinks about me. Because what I just said today, they're going to see on the internet, and I know someone's going to be upset. But I care about what God thinks about me. This is what it's about. What is our mission? Our mission in a church on the run is what? To get ministers out there to plant churches. To get people to leave this building and get on the firing line. If you come here and receive Christ, I love you. I don't want you to leave, but I'm asking you to. I'm asking you to leave with a Bible under your arm and a God in your heart. That's what I'm asking you. I'm asking you to plant a church. I want you to be the church. I want to be in your heart. I want you to cry when you drive by a jail. I want you to cringe when you go by a psychiatric office. I want you to look at some homeless person on a street saying, we'll do something for food, and not even say in your heart, they're going to waste it on drugs. I want you to reach in and take your wallet, take your ID out.